This video will walk through how to ask a question using Metabase's graphical query builder. Let's say we have a question like, how many orders did our company receive in 2019 by product category? We'll start up here in the navigation bar by clicking New and Question. If we wanted to write our question in SQL, we'd click SQL Query. This brings us to the notebook editor, where we'll first need to select our data source. Our options are models, which are derived tables that you or someone in your organization has created as a good starting point for new questions, raw data, or saved questions. You may not see all of these options. We'll select raw data and choose the orders table in the sample database that ships with Metabase. Now that we've selected our data, we can preview our table with this triangle button on the right. Asking a question about your data usually consists of doing two things, filtering and summarizing. We want to filter our results based on when orders were created. If we click this Add Filter button, we'll see a dropdown showing us the columns that we can filter on. These icons next to the filter options give us some idea of what type of column each one is, and each type of column gives us different filtering options. If we want to filter based on how many orders were created in 2019, we'll need to choose the Created At column. The default option is to filter by the previous 30 days, but we want to reach a bit further back than that. Let's click this first dropdown and select Between. Now we can enter the dates that we're interested in, which in our case are the beginning of January through the end of December 2019. Let's add that filter, and we can preview our results at this stage too. As you can see, everything in the Created At column is from 2019. Now we want to count how many orders there are, and then we'll break that number out by product category. This is one example of summarizing, which typically means counting, adding, or averaging, and then optionally grouping that result by time, location, or some other dimension. The first option in this list of metrics is count of rows, which, as the name suggests, counts the number of rows in the table. This is the option we want for our question of how many orders were placed in 2019. Next, we need to pick the dimension that we want to group by, which is product category. We'll scroll down to product and select category. Let's visualize our results. Metabase immediately calculates for us and chooses the most appropriate default visualization, which in this case is a bar chart. If we wanted to switch to table view, we can do so by clicking this toggle at the bottom. Now, if we wanted to see a different date range, we can edit our filter just by clicking on it. We can also remove our filter with this X or hide the filter with this purple Hide Filters button. We can also add and adjust filters using the filter button in the upper right, which brings out a sidebar where we can do just that. Let's open the Summarize sidebar, which, as you'll see, is broken up into two parts. The top is where we'll select how we want to summarize the data, and the bottom is where we'll choose what kind of grouping we want. We can also add additional metrics here, like if we wanted to calculate the average subtotal or the sum of the quantity column. But for now, let's just keep count selected. A neat thing about the sidebar is that we can change our summarizations while still viewing the data. Like if we wanted to switch over and see how many orders were created by month, we'd scroll down to Created At by month, and Metabase generates a line chart for us showing us the count of orders throughout 2019 broken out by month. And if we wanted to see orders created at by month and by product category, we can scroll down to product category and click this plus icon to add that grouping. This gives us a color-coded line chart showing how each of our product categories performed throughout 2019 by month. Each of these lines represents one of our four product categories. If you ever want to return to the notebook editor, you can do so by clicking this Show Editor button in the upper right. If we aren't satisfied with a line chart, we can click the Visualization button in the lower left to see our other options. We can also adjust the settings, like the display colors or the scale of the axes. If you're ever feeling a bit lost playing around with filters and summarizations, and you just want to get back to your starting table, you can do so by clicking the table name up at the top. This shows you your starting table without any of those filters or summarizations added. A nice shortcut when viewing a table is to click on any of these column headings to quickly filter or summarize by that column. For example, we can click the subtotal heading, filter by this column, and have it only show us orders where the subtotal was greater than $40. In the lower right, we can download our results or create alerts for our new questions. That's it for our quick tour of asking questions in Metabase. We've only just scratched the surface of what you can do in Metabase, so have fun, and thanks for watching.